exciting action for the Quinnipiac volleyball team exclusively here on the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. Make sure you also check out more game summaries and feature articles only at theqbsn.com.
Well, everybody's heard about the bird.
Hey, Bobcat fans. Looking for the best fried chicken fingers around? Go to Griff's Chicken Shack.
Griff's giant chicken fingers are pure white meat, always fresh and never frozen. They're seasoned in a savory marinade, hand-battered and served fresh and hot every time.
Check out the menu.
And we're back here on the DQBSN, the final here with Quinnipiac Women's Soccer coming away with a 1-0 victory as we are joined here by head coach of the Bobcats. And thanks, Coach, for coming on with us. Just talk about coming in, as you said, a rough game this week against Lehigh and able to turn around and come away with the victory today.
It was important to break the streak. You know, we've been in the same position the last couple of years where we haven't started well results-wise. And this was probably the worst, no, not probably, this was the worst performance of the season. And ironically enough, we end up winning 1-0. But on such things, does your season change? You know, that you now all of a sudden we've had a shutout, we've had a win, we broke the streak, and then we've got a week to prepare for Sacred Heart and then another week for Fairleigh Dickinson. So,
yeah, there's going into conference play, and just that goal by Beck Kiting was really kind of off the free kick there by Jill. Kind of it seemed like a broken play in the box, and then just able to come away with the goal. Was anything really particular drawn up in that, or was it
no,
sort of
I mean,
just
statistically, the more times the ball's in the penalty area? We've been working on trying to get them to understand that we don't always have to keep possession in front of their penalty area. And that was one of those. We're getting Jill in, at least just gamble. And they didn't clear it because we have so many bodies. Fortuna doesn't get a clear pass in, but it, just the missed kick causes so many problems. And then Becky does what she does well. Becky Keating, by the way, did what she does well and wrapped her foot around it and good finish.
Yeah, as you said, now you have a week before Sacred Heart. And you said, ironically, the worst performance. But so what do you guys have to change going into that game?
I think they have to believe in themselves more. We've got some very, very good players in here. But if things don't go their way, they just can't panic. They've got to settle down, be it Shauna, Fortuna, Christina, Crystal, all of these players. There's a lot of talent there. And they've just got to say, you know what, we're not going to go out and beat teams 4-5-0. We've just got to get the first goal first and then let everything else take care of itself after that. We're still not on the same page. We're still playing in, you know, the back four together and not connected with the forwards and midfields with the back four and vice versa. So we've got a week to tidy up a few things. We'll watch the game and see if there's anything that stands out. And if not, we'll just reinforce what we've been working on for the last month.
All right. Thanks, Coach, and congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
We're going to be joined now by Beck Kiting coming away with the goal. And the lone goal in the Bobcats win today, and thanks for joining us. And first win of the year, and how's it feel?
It feels great. We've been trying to get out the first win of the game, the first win of the season this weekend, and we're pretty disappointed with our performance on Friday, so we're just happy that we could get away with the win today.
Right, and anything that you guys changed from the game on Friday against Lehigh going into today?
I think, like Dave said, we just sat down as a team yesterday and we're just like, we have great players on the team. We've got good individual players and it's now time just to start playing as a team and just believing that we can win and believing that we can do well in this tournament this year.
Right. And just go through, as you said, sort of somewhat of a broken play there, but you're able to, put a foot on it and put it in the back of the net. So what happened there?
Yeah, I think before the game, we had a lot of free kicks around the halfway line on the game on Friday against Lehigh, and we couldn't capitalise on any of them. So this time we decided to get Jill Kelly up from the back to take those kicks so she could get them right in there. And the ball was just bouncing around, and I just thought I was just going to get on the end of this and see what happens.
So now as you guys move into conference play, so little things you have to change, but so what do you think you guys look forward to in moving forward and coming up into conference play?
I think just getting some wins on the board, just getting on a bit of a roll. We had a slow start last season as well to the league as well. So we just got to get some wins on the board now, and then we look forward to moving on.
All right. Thank you for joining us, and congrats on the win.
Thank you very much.
So we're going to be joined back here by James Corey. And, James, just any last-minute thoughts here what happened here today following the victory?
Oh, I thought it was funny how Coach said, ironically, it's the worst game they ever played, and they come out with the win. So, I mean, that just kind of says how much better they can play with their potential.
Definitely, as we said, kind of funny to hear, ironically, it's the worst they've played, but definitely a difference from the game on Friday against Lehigh where they lost 4-2, but they move on to conference play. Looking at the schedule, like Coach said, they play at Sacred Heart on September 23rd, so they'll have a good amount of time before they go there and play next Friday, and then the week after they head back down to Fairleigh Dickinson. So they have 2 weeks really in for two games, so they should be fresh as now they go into conference play. And we said, heard Bex Keating say, you know, want to try and get some wins under their belt and just move on. So any final thoughts on the day here, James?
Well, getting the first win of the season is definitely, you know, crucial for them now. I think that's just going to open a lot of opportunities up for them. They can start playing a lot better, I think. You know, I mean, getting a first win could be, you know, annoying, I guess, trying for it. So getting it out of the way is definitely good for them.
Right, and so Quinnipiac moves to 1-4-1 on the year. The Crusaders of Holy Cross drop to 2-5. We'd like to put a lot of thanks out there, first and foremost, to the athletic director here at Quinnipiac, Mr. Jack McDonald, for making everything possible, as well as sports information, Ken Sweeten, Ross Bennett, and Lindsay Oliveri for the stats and keeping us updated with player interviews. We'd like to thank the co-directors of the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, myself and Mark Schwartz, for James Corey and Matthias Gauss, saying so long from the Quinnipiac field, Quinnipiac soccer field. The Bobcats come away with the first win of the year, 1-0 over Holy Cross.